Okay, great, everybody. We got this bad file in today from a very concerned lady. She tried everything she said, and she just couldn't get this file opened. And you'll see when we try to open it in InDesign, we get this very ominous, cannot open. Clearly, it's not opening. So what do we do? We try our Markzware method of going into QuarkXPress 8, and using our tool, ID to Q, and convert that InDesign into Quark. Now, it is a bad file, so it is a risky attempt, but our research and testing has shown us that it's working. So we choose that file that just did not open in InDesign, and we get our conversion options through ID to Q, InDesign to Quark conversion. That will take InDesign files, good and bad, it appears, and convert them into Adobe InDesign. Now we see it's converting the file. It's making progress. It's very good. Let's zoom out here, give you more of a complete view. We'll see that it's actually creating all the colors and styles used in the file, recreating them in effect. And, 10, 15, 20%, who knows, it's hard to say, but a certain amount of time it fails. It'll just, get the beach ball of death spinning here and won't complete the conversion on the bad files, huh? Generally works fine with good files. But as we can see here, it is making progress, and this is a good sign. So we just patiently wait, maybe take a sip of our coffee here. And I'm showing you this for a reason, because we have other films showing you how successful we have been recovering and fixing these bad InDesign files. But this one runs into a twist at the end of the converting the bad file in QuarkXPress. Now, so far so good. Everything is looking fine. We would expect the file to pop up a little bit quicker here, and that's one sign that things might not be going as smoothly as they should. Spins. Now we see the file. It looks, all sides looking good. Let's always wanted to zoom in on the beach ball. Don't you just love that beach ball? All signs looking good, but I still can't get to my data. I'm so close. So close to helping this lady here. And as it will turn out, yet so far away. What's going to happen, that's why I'm filming here, is we're going to crash. There we go. Not a good sign. Quark has just crashed. It's not Quark's fault. I mean, this is a bad Adobe InDesign file that we're converting with Markzware's ID to Q into Quark. So the file has some problems. So we're just gonna back out here. And we're now going to see one of the great things in QuarkXPress 8 is they create a Quark Rescue folder. And inside that folder is your rescued file. So if we now try to open this again in Quark, we should be able to, get going with this file again. It's a great feature in the newer Quarks. We have Markz tools for fixing bad Quark files, which there still are out there, but this has helped a lot because many times if your file crashes because of a small corruption reason, you can recover it. And in this Quark Rescue folder, you often find a file which might need repairing, might even not open. You might still need our Markz tools to help open that. And Markz tools, by the way, also helps prevent your files from going bad in the first place. But in any event, here we see it's loading. It appears to be working. But we run into another little twist in the road, a little curve, a little hairpin turn that turns out to be a little more difficult than we thought. But it says there's been some minor repairs. Do you want to fix it? We say yes. Now remember, this is a bad Adobe InDesign file that we could not open in InDesign. It just wouldn't allow us. That was crashing Quark and ID to Q. That even needed repaired from after we took the Quark Rescued folder. And here, finally, we've done it. We've recovered the complete file. And as we can see, it's no small file. It's quite a complex magazine. Items on the pasteboard, images all over, etc., etc. So, This is what I would consider a very successful Adobe InDesign file that's been corrupted, recovered with Markzware's ID to Q, and then finally we get it back into Adobe InDesign because this person has Adobe InDesign with Markzware's Q to ID running in Adobe InDesign. It's kind of like a round trip. We go from InDesign, a bad InDesign file, into Quark. From Quark, we go back into Adobe InDesign. We go in here in InDesign. We go up to our Q to ID item up top here. Convert QuarkXPress document. We'll choose that file. We'll hit open. And now you see we're converting back into InDesign. Once again, it's a pretty big document, pretty complex. It takes a little bit of time here, but still very reasonable with all things considered. This file was done. She tried everything to open it. She was ready to restart on that file, and you saw it was no small file. That would have taken days of work for perhaps multiple people. That was no, it's a situation none of us want to be in. So here we go. But anyway, by the way, sorry about my messy desktop, but I thought, just get this movie going real quick here so everyone can see it. And we see, finally, that bad InDesign file is back to life again. Everything complete. All the text flowing in nicely and ready to be used. File save as. What I also recommend is after you fix bad files is you don't only do a file save as, you actually should export as an InDesign inter-exchange file, which can be opened in CS3 or CS4, even CS2, so that you can, it sort of decorrupts any small corruption that might be in there. Of course, now we've probably fixed it with this conversion. Most of the time it fixes anything. But there you go. Thank you very much. Markzware signing off. Have a great weekend.